Hello and welcome to day two Docker challenge video. In this video, we're going to learn how to run unit tests from within a container. If you are beginning with Docker and don't know yet what Docker is and how to sort of get started, then watch my previous video. The link should be showing up in the YouTube video now. You could, in the previous video, learn how to get started with Docker, how to containerize an ASP.NET core app, how to build it, how to publish it to Docker Hub, all using Azure DevOps with YAML pipelines. In this video, we're going to talk about running unit tests in that container and then publish those unit test results into Azure DevOps so we can visualize the test results. So stay tuned, wait till the end. There is a lot of good stuff in this video. So in this multi-stage Docker file, we're taking the ASP.NET core image, great, and as the next step in the next phase, we're building our web project and copying the published assemblies into the container and then going about setting an entry point into that container. Now what we're missing here is building the test project and then executing the test from within this container. Now let's go ahead and see how we would go about doing that. We're currently in the context of source myweb. Let's print the directory. And that's for what I've written run ls. And the next step, let's change the work directory to the root, which is src. And now what we will do is we will copy the test project myweb.test.csproj into a new directory under the root, which would be called myweb.test. Let's first do a .NET restore on myweb.test project to restore any dependencies we have in that project. Let's copy all the results into that folder. And next up, we're gonna change the work directory now in the context of the myweb.test project. And we're going to build that project by running run.net build myweb.test.csproj. Now we're going to run this in the release configuration and output into app build folder. At this point, we're ready to run the test. We have to specify the test project, and I'm going to append a logger with which I would output the test results execution into a TRX file. Let's just give it a name for the log file. Let's call it myweb_test.trx. And at this point, we could just print the output of that directory